The power of prayer and ceremony is very important, and I spent a lot of my time writing prayers and answering questions about prayers. And what I have discovered in my learning about prayers is that prayers simply are a way for us to voice our opinion, our thoughts, not to ourselves, but to a creator, to a universe, something greater than ourselves. And I know that people spend a lot of time preparing to pray when all they need to do is just speak. The power of prayer is important because it can make a shift. It can make a shift in the universe. It can make a shift in the hearts of people who are praying. And it's not meant to be something that is practiced or performed or rehearsed. It's just simply to speak from your heart. And when you speak from your heart, then your true feelings are known. In the Hopi way, when we pray with cornmeal. And cornmeal is like our messenger to the Creator. When we pray, we are told that we pray not for ourselves first. Our first prayer is for rain, that we always pray for rain because water is the source of all life. Then our next prayer is for other people, for the universe, for other creatures on the earth. And that is so that the energy will continue to flow. And then our last prayer is for ourselves. But by the time you get to yourself, you've prayed for everything around you, and that prayer has already been prayed. So then you can ask with gratitude for what you want, what your desires in life are, and for the Creator's guidance, but always being grateful. Ceremony is also very important because it is part of prayer. And my belief is actually what I think about ceremony is that ceremony has to begin with a belief that is true to you, not something that somebody else practices, not something that somebody else has told you, but what you truly believe. And a ceremony is created on this, and it starts with a ritual. You create a ritual using prayer as part of your ritual, which now creates a ceremony. So with belief as your basis, what do you believe in? What are you going to create a ritual around? Now what's your ceremony going to be? And that's how we hold ourselves true to our own beliefs, to our own prayers. What is your ceremony that you create for peace? What is the ceremony you create for happiness? What is the ceremony you create for spiritual growth? Those are important ceremonies that we have to learn how to do a ritual for so that it now can support our belief. If I believe in happiness, I start my day with a song, with something that's going to make me feel happy. Then I may eat something that will make me feel good, so that now my tummy is happy. And then now I go out in a place and surround myself with people that will tell me a joke or that will laugh with me, not at me, but with me. Now I've created a ceremony, and that's why ceremonies are important. And they are meant for the individual. And when you find a group of people that are performing the same ceremony, then that's when you get a whole collective consciousness that can move the universe. And that is why I am devoted and committed to this gathering, because I think that we can start to create ceremonies that is going to promote love and well-being with humanity.